All right, what's up, guys? Silver Nectanola here, back doing another coaching video. Today we're doing a different champion than Renekton, which is nice. This is from Kanto is Godlike. He's gonna be playing Olaf today, and he is against, I'm assuming, Gangplank. Let's move these around a little bit, get them all lined up. Hopefully. There we go. All right, sweet. I like the skin choice. Very good. Yeah, Corruption Potion is so good on Olaf. A lot of times you can get long trades with Olaf. So the thing with the Corruption Potion is each time you hit them and it refreshes the damage buff, right? So anytime you're doing damage to them, the whole time they have this 15 damage over 3 seconds. That's what it is at level 1 or whatever. Yeah, so they'll be taking this magic damage over time the entire duration of the fight, and then they'll take it for 3 seconds after the last time you hit them. So you get so much extra damage with the Corruption Potion. It also gives you mana and health, which is really good on a champion like Olaf, where you need both, especially mana, which can be kind of an issue in the early game. I think Gangplank should have actually went Corruption Potion as well. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention this is in silver, but it's going to be in the title or thumbnail or whatever, so you guys will know. Overall, this is a really good matchup for Olaf. The reason why it's really good for Olaf is you can just throw your axe at Gangplank. Anytime Gangplank's like extended far up in the lane, he doesn't have an escape. So if you just hit him with an axe, he has to blow his orange to get out of the slow. And then you can just run and pick up the axe and hit him again. So and then he slowed again. You can get really aggressive at level 1 once he blows his true damage. Like right here, you should be throwing another axe and going for him. It's looking like you're just going to push the wave. Pushing waves against Gangplank early is pretty decent too. It's a little bit of trouble last hitting on your tower. Yeah, but you're trading into his passive there. One more axe on the way out. Nice. You can E him. Should have got your E. If you level it up quick enough, you could have easily got it there. Maybe an extra auto attack. You'd just be a little bit lower in HP. Hold on, let me go back. I want to see your... Okay, you did pop it. Nice. I want to make sure you were popping your... Let's see. To be popped right now. The first time you take a damage... So you missed maybe 2 seconds of extra damage. That would have been nice. Right here, you level up and E him, and you can easily get an extra little hit there. I think you just turn and kill him right at that point, to be honest. He took a lot of damage from this little creep. Look at this one. You're just following him, hitting him. That was great. Hit him like 3 times. Yeah, you could add your Corruption Potion, taking a little bit earlier. Got a little bit extra damage off. Pretty much the second you start any trade with like Olaf, you want to pop your Corruption Potion. With the axe. So you got most of those CS. You missed 4. Not the worst. Could be a little bit better, even though you're trying to harass and stuff. You should really aim for like 17 creeps on the first 3 waves. There's 19 total, so you should really aim for like 17. A little bit of a rough trade there. What you probably want to be doing in this scenario is just being very careful with the... with last hitting, and just last hit only, because you're really extended, or you want a hard shove. So, you just threw an axe, so you should definitely try and hard shove. So you should be hitting the creeps as much as possible. It's only 3 minutes, so it's really unlikely that the jungler is going to gank you at this point. Okay. So you end up doing like the passive route, where you just wait for the wave to push, but you keep throwing your axe. It's kind of confusing your management here. You're going to shove it, kind of, and then you're going to let it push. Now you're just kind of leaving it in a shitty spot for too long. I think you just bite the bullet, eat the damage, and shove this under tower. Because, like, right around 4 minutes and 30, 4 minutes and 20 is when you can expect a gank. So now you're, like, overextended in, like, a shitty situation. You don't even have that great of a ward because you misplaced it. Ooh. We're getting some trouble here. Yeah, this is just because poor wave management. You could have easily had the wave like all the way back in your area. All right, let's just back up a little bit. Talk about that. So it's kind of interesting. All right, so like right here, it's like even creeps, but it's on his side of the map, so it's gonna push back to you, right? So as long as you don't do something like throwing your axe through a bunch of creeps, as long as you basically just last hit, this wave is gonna always shove back to you. So in like, it'll be like two waves from now, right? Not this wave, not the next, not this one spawning, but the next one. So in about a minute, right? That's when this will be like over here. Okay, so if you just let it push and you only last hit, you'll be in a much better spot. But instead, you try and harass a little bit in queue. You're running low on mana anyways, and your ward's going to time out relatively shortly. It's halfway done, so you really should have just left this push out. See right here how it's he has extra minions? It's 4. It was 7 against 6, so it was going to shove out. So like once you do this axe, what you have to do is commit to it. So you have to shove and wipe this wave into tower. But you like kind of half did it and half didn't do it, so you... You could have let that first wave shove, but then you should have decided not to. So you should have actually cleared this, and since you didn't, you stalled it long enough that the next wave is going to come and catch, and it's not going to wipe under tower. So then you're stuck in this weird spot where you're overextended again. And now your ward's really about the timeout. So throwing those axes were not that great. I mean, if you could have finished a kill, it would have been like okay, but you're running teleport and stuff, you know. It's going to be really unlikely. And now you're like in a position where you're overextended, your ward died so you don't have any vision, and now you're just going to... I mean, I don't think you're going to die here. He's got true damage, but I don't think you're dead here, yeah. Because you can just throw an axe and slow. Oh wow, you're going to die. Is your axe on cooldown? Gotta throw that axe, dude. Yeah, you gotta throw that axe. You gotta slow them. Your axe is up, right? Yeah, okay. So, like, right after you flash, boom, you throw your axe. This guy can't catch you after that, because he's gonna have to wait until he can speed it up and stun you again. I mean, he does have flash, though. He does have flash, so maybe he could have still finished it, but I don't know. I feel like if you throw an axe, you have a lot of potential to get away. And even if you still die, throwing that axe guarantees that at least one of them is going to have to flash, if not both. So throwing an axe there would have guaranteed flashes from your enemy, which would have been at least something. But the main problem was how you managed your creep wave. You could have easily allowed that to just shove back toward you. And you had another ward that you could have dropped too. So if you're going to stay extended like that, you need to get a ward down so you can respond a little bit quicker. If you have a vision of Olaf coming or Udyr coming in, you can get to like, you could have been like here by the time he actually, you know, gets you instead of here. So then you're flashing here and then, you know, it's less time that you have to run to your tower. Makes it easier to get away. So you're in a really good spot here because this guy has no mana. So it'd be great if... to just like ping and let your jungler know. But right now you're like pretty extended, so I think Udyr is clearly in a spot that he can just 1v1 you, so you gotta be a little bit careful about being this extended, because he could literally have just stayed top, done like double golems and came right back and killed you. And this isn't like the same situation. I mean, once you get level 6 you won't really be able to do that, because you can just pop your Ragnarok and just shit on the gangplank. But yeah, getting your wards down, very good. Probably should have done it before you came to the wave. Especially since the wave was pushing to you, you weren't obligated to get to the wave immediately and not miss creeps. So the wave was shoving to you, the first one that you got back to. So you could have easily just walked warded first and then gone to the wave. So I like what you're doing right now. You're poking with your axe. Really good. You have a pretty high mana pool. You never want to sit with 100% mana, because it just doesn't make any sense. You don't get any... Oh, wow. E. Oh! Could have gotten very aggressive there. Oh, I'm sorry, your E was on cooldown. Use it on a creep. That's right. Yeah, you just use it on that creep. Okay. Hold up, did you get this slow on him before you were in tower range? Yeah. I feel like you might have been able to... Well, you didn't force his flash out before, so never mind. You'd never be able to finish this, but... You hit the axe right here out of tower range, so you can just walk in and pick that axe up. Even if he queues this barrel, he has just enough mana to queue, right? So even if he queues this barrel, who gives a shit? It slows you. It doesn't kill both the creeps. It only kills one. This creep would still be alive and eat one tower shot. And then you have your axe that you just picked up, and you can just land it again and walk up and hit him once after the slow ends. You wouldn't have tower aggro because there was creeps that walked in the tower first. Oh, okay. Or you can just do that. Oh, man. Q-Max does so much damage. Especially against a guy who has no armor. Yeah, like this. Just shove the wave. Look to get a back off. Make him TP if he has it. An extra 10 gold. I like it. CSing is meh. Could be better. It's mainly because you died to the Udyr ganks. What are you doing, bud? You got all this gold. What are we waiting on? You got 1,000 gold. What are we waiting on? This is a wave that's gonna shove to us. Dude, I don't understand why the pause button doesn't work, man. It's kind of irritating. This is a wave that's gonna shove to you. So whenever you can always leave in this spot and like walk back to lane. Maybe you're trying to buy like a certain item. And I don't see it. Yeah, you definitely need to back, man. You're sitting on so much gold. Doesn't matter that you just killed him. You don't. Yeah, he missed a huge back timing window. You can still back right now and come out ahead. It's even creeps on his side of the map. Anytime that you see that, it's going to shove to you. So that means you could back and come back to lane and there'd be a big creep wave like right outside your tower that you could get. You need to spend your gold, man. You're sitting on 1,300 gold. That's nuts. He has an item advantage on you right now, even though you killed him. That doesn't make any sense. You're way overstaying. How long did we stay for? I mean, it doesn't really matter that much. You're just kind of clearing the wave, but if you bought items, you could be like so much more aggressive. Now you're pinging for assistance. You don't need assistance. You need to back. Just shove this wave and back. Alright, please back. Please back. You have 1,500 gold. You might get a dive now, though. Oh, man. If you die now, I'm gonna cry. You can kill him. Pick up your axe and fall. You overshot your first axe. You want to throw these just long enough to... you got creep blocked kind of hard there. Nice. Get out of there! You're pretty dead. Yeah. So first off, you have like a shit ton of gold on you that you really shouldn't have, and you should have just backed. But that's okay. Just wanna look at these axes again. So it's like this first axe that you could have done work right here, because if you short this axe and you get it just past him, you can grab it and have thrown like two more times. But you throw it super far. That was like max range. You could have thrown it right there and picked it up again right here, thrown it again, picked it up again right here, and thrown it again. You would have thrown three axes. Instead, it was so far away. And then even this one is like pretty far too. You're just lucky he runs into it. What Gangplank should do is run this way immediately when you throw an axe. But he runs kind of toward it, so you get like a little bit lucky. But yeah, you could have killed him super easy. And then you would have been mad. Do you have your W almost up? No. Okay. You still would have died to this guy probably. But you would have had like 200 to 300 extra health. And maybe been able to like outplay this guy and run this way and slow him. Yeah, dude, you would definitely survive because you would have killed him like right here. I'm out. You would have definitely killed him way earlier. Let's speed this up. Alright. You get another one right here. You get another one right here. Yeah, you hit him with two axes already. He's definitely dead. Two axes, you would have autoed two more times and killed him. So he would have been dead and you would have 500 HP. And you could have easily ran this way, because right here was where Azir was. You didn't see him, but you would have saw him and still been able to run away. Azir wouldn't have bursted you for 500 health with three Ragnarok up still. So you would have been able to get out of there. Definitely need to work on your axes. But the main thing there was you didn't spend your freaking gold. You way overstayed. I mean, it's nice to see how much gold you can get, but you had like 3, 4, 5 opportunities to back. I mean, trading one for one's okay, but really want to look for better situations. I understand that you're trying to get Master Yi to gank for you, but you still just want to. Like, he had an item advantage, so even when you're getting a gank, it's still, like, way weaker than it possibly could be. And then if their jungler's there, he just turns it around because it's two people with way more gold spent than you. You're, like, sitting on like, multiple items. Like, it's, yeah. Definitely need to have backed earlier. Right after you force him, you shove that one wave after you forced him, after you killed him, you shove that one wave and then you back. That's all you gotta do. It wasn't even like it was a special item that you were trying to get. Overstayed. Because what happens when you overstay like that is you end up losing a bunch of pressure. Because you played like a bitch after, right? Like you were afraid to do too much aggression because you didn't have wards. Yeah, now if you just hit an axe, you kill him. Unfortunate. You miss. Hit an axe, you kill him. Oh, man. Hit the axe! Alright. I mean, that's just mechanical stuff. You just gotta hit the axes. This is like the perfect situation in this matchup. You want GP overextended in the lane, and then you just run him down with Ragnarok and hit axes. It looks like you're looking for the TP. There's nothing really to TP into. Oh, you TP'd bot, huh? Oop. Let me catch it coming in. Alright, so with all this fighting, I wouldn't have TP'd mid. I think that. Is this a TP4 mid? It looks like it is, because you started running this way, kind of. Or are you TPing for this guy? It seems like an awful TP, because you're, like, never getting this guy. Yeah. You're never getting him. If he E'd forward, maybe, and you saw it, and then tried to TP in, I could understand that. But you're never killing Ezreal. He's way too shifty. Okay. And before you come up behind him and kill his ass. He turns around to fight you? No way. What an idiot. What an idiot. Does he know what your passive does? How you get retarded attack speed when you're low HP and he goes melee form? Alright, that's some silver play. So you get kind of rewarded for a bad teleport. You actually gave up a lot of farm in top lane. It's pretty unfortunate. Ooh. Azir trying to make the big plays. Not happening. Whoa, why are you gonna walk forward after you pulled? It's like people who play Teemo and they use their move quick and then they run forward at you after it's like over. It's like, ah, dude, that was your escape. You have no escape up. I'm just gonna come kill you. So definitely the axes need a little bit of work. You're overshooting them a little bit. Or not a little bit, a lot of it. You're like max ranging some of these. And you can maximize your DPS by a ton. And then that overstay was really rough too. Yeah, don't try and TP against like someone like Ezreal. He's just gonna get away. Even if you landed an axe too, like you did well. Oh, this is really good. Alright, nice, you got his flash. Good job. Get these back ones first. Nice. Yeah, no sense in missing out on any of these. At this point you just want to hardcore shove this. Because you chunked him out. I mean, you're really not going to deny any creeps by waiting. Oh, you're typing something, huh? That was the I'm typing stop. Okay. Let's get some vision around. Do you have another one? The trinkets are always bugged in spectators, so I can't tell if you have two up or not. I think you probably do, so if you have two up, you should ward this. You don't have your TP up, so your team should probably not be doing all these dragon shenanigans, but... Ooh. It's a pretty nice play. Flash to put yourself right on top of him. You know he doesn't have flash because you just forced it with the play right before. Yep, right when you hit him with the axe, it's over. You just flash right on top of that axe. Yep, perfect. Pick it up. You clipped an auto. A little bit unfortunate. Get that one, though. Boom. Nice. Good play. Now you just shove this in. You can't really do anything about this. You don't have your TP up or anything. If you had your TP up, imagine making a TP play into this. Oh, there's really nothing to TP to. You'd be all the way over here. Yeah, I don't think you'd do anything. Damn, that Ezreal's fed now. That's going to be an issue. You're still behind quite a bit, CS, because of that TP. And you just kind of haven't been doing as well as the GP and CSing. I mean, it's definitely easier for... Well, I don't know if I'd say it was easier for GP to CS. You just kind of... I don't know. The reason why the buying thing was a really big issue is because there was like four waves that you stayed or five waves that you stayed for, and all those five waves, you were missing like multiple creeps because you were afraid to walk up. Like, you were missing like all the backline creeps in some of the waves. So like, I would estimate you missed probably 20 creeps right there because you were afraid, when you could have just backed earlier, missed nothing, like literally missed like six creeps, the same amount that he missed when walking back to lane. And even came out in a benefit because the wave would have been shoved to you over here. And you would have had items spent, so you would have been stronger to fight. You wouldn't have had to have been afraid, and you would have got all those extra CS. So it literally cost you like 20 CS. That's actually a pretty big deal. Alright, maybe not 20, but it's like 15-ish. Yeah, this guy's true passive up. You definitely don't want to all-in fight that. If you had your W here, maybe you fight that. Because I feel like you can turn if you had your W up. But you obviously don't in that situation, so... Good on you to not. Oh, okay. The Master Yi, though. Oh no! He baited you. Yeah, if you didn't know, when Master Yi uses his Q, he goes in. Basically, it's like invulnerable. And, yeah. Tower drops aggro. I feel like you could have hit an axe and then walked out. Actually, no. I think he was just dead to Yi, but Yi would have died. Well, I guess that would have been better, because then he would have just traded one for one, plus you get an assist. Because he died anyways in here. So maybe that would have been better, in the wave shoving to you. So I don't know. Maybe that would have been slightly better. But overall, you're playing quite well. Just missing some CS. Throwing a little bit of too long axes. Like, just kind of some mechanical stuff. But obviously, there was a big flaw with that. The backing timing. Now, this is a really good spot. This is, like, the ideal spot. You don't want to shove this. No. This is, like, the dream against in this matchup. This is what you're waiting for. You're waiting for Gangplank to have to be super over. Look at all this distance. I can't even show Gangplank on the screen right now. This is so much distance he's got to cover. This is, like, the spot you want to be. You hit one axe here, you just kill his ass. You got your Ragnarok up. He still doesn't have flash. If you're timing that, this is a free kill. I think you're looking to TP or something, but if you hit an axe here, you just go. Yeah, you hit that axe, man. You just go. This is such a huge distance for him to have to cover. There's no way he does it. You hit one axe, what does he do? He has to pop his W. You grab your other axe and hit another one, and you just reapply the slow. He's got his Triforce spike though, so he is quite powerful, but you still shit on him in like a actual fight. Some of your minion control has just been off. Like, you could have really punished him for being all the way over here, and you could have froze the wave, but you let it like, yeah. You could have like cleared some of the minions and froze the wave. Like, you had many options there. You could have cleared some of the minions and froze the wave, or you could have just all-in after you hit an axe, which is what you probably should have done, because you can just chain axes. If you can land them, he's 100% dead, because you can hit like seven axes. Like, imagine he has infinite health, right? You could probably hit like eight or nine axes on him from here to there. Like, that's such a huge distance to cover. Again, you're throwing your axe too far, but this should still be a free kill. One more auto. Another one that was a little bit far, but it's alright. Nice. Yeah. Ragnarok is just so good against Gangplank. Once you hit him with a Q once, you just run him down. This is a really, really good matchup. I like Olaf a lot here. I don't know why you're not being more aggressive right here. I would have probably taken that tower right there. You have double vision. You're very safe. You know mid's dead. You just hit tab and you can see that. You know, Gangplank's dead. There you go. Whatever, you still get it in the end. Clear this next wave and leave. I like that. You're like full health right now. I don't think it's Gangplank just spawned. He doesn't have ultimate, so he's not going to come. And then, well, he is going to come, but he's not going to be there in time. And then if Udyr is like in the area, he can't 1v1 you at this point, so I like that. Once you get your Black Cleaver, like, what the fuck is Olaf going to do? Or, sorry, I keep saying Olaf when I mean Udyr. What is Udyr going to do against Olaf who's got Black Cleaver? Like, nothing. How much gold do you have? 1,800. Let's see what we buy. I just really like Swifties in this game. I mean, sure, armor's going to be nice, but I just feel like Swifties are so good. How are you killing Gangplank? You just run him down. So more movement speed is clearly better. So I feel like Swiftness Boots is just an amazing buy. So you could have done Swiftness Boots. What would have been a sick buy is Swiftness Boots. You could still get the Maw. I mean, the Spectral Cowl. I don't know. It seems kind of weak, though. Like, who's fed on their team? It's Ezreal, you know? I love how you can just walk right through that. Yeah, I actually don't like the special cowl at all. What are we getting that for? The Azir? If Azir is like blowing all of his damage into you, you're gonna win the fight. Is this guy Phoenix? Yeah, he is. I mean, I guess it's okay. I feel like armor would just be a little bit better. Like, go toward your dead man's plate. Oh, nope. Yeah, man. Swiftness Boots, you would have caught his ass. See if you could have done something a little bit better. I like the... Oh, see? It's these axes, man. It's these axes. Alright, so you kill this guy, right? It's his, watch his axe. So you get a nice vision of this guy. You see him. You want to make your play. Oh, we throw an axe. It hits him. Nice. Oh, wait. We can't get it. And that's our issue. So now we have to wait another 4 seconds, whereas... If he threw an axe right here, we pick it up right now, and we throw it again here. So he's already slowed again. And then we pick it up here, and he's slowed again here. Pick it up here, he's slowed again here. You know, we get 5 more axes just by throwing this one in a decent spot. So he probably could have killed him off of that first axe. Ends up getting caught. Round 2. That's a good one. That one misses. And then it's the exhaust. What you should have done is waited for the exhaust to end and throw your axe, and you would have killed him. All you had to do is wait like a tiny second more. Unfortunate. But yeah, if it's about shorting, you gotta throw those axes right where you want them. You know, it goes. You can't just aim max range at that shit. Cause that 4 second cooldown lost you a free kill, and you even missed another one over here too. Destroyed. Your team's not having a good time. Yi's doing quite well. Vlad's doing meh. Teleporting behind. Unfortunately, it's not 20 minutes yet. Pop your ult right away. Not much use to do that. Alright. I mean, not much use for the ult there, but other than that, it's fine. It's such a risky play where you just saw them all mid and you have no help. You're gonna get punished, huh? Oh, yeah. All in here. Yeah, you gotta just turn at the end there. You're dead. You just gotta turn to fight. You gotta remember, you got that crazy passive speed, attack speed, so that plus your W. You can get crazy amount of healing out. But yeah, that was just a really bad play. You just saw them in mid. Like, you have a ward there. They were just right there. So you can't try and, like, solo dragon without your team there to support. Udyr trying to 1v9. Managing to actually do it. The heal. Alright, he should clean this up. This guy's very tanky. Oh shit, he's in trouble. Oh man, this entire time the fed Ezreal is free hitting. Jesus. This guy is quite tanky. How much armor does Udyr have? Oh yeah, dude, Udyr is very tanky against the Yi. Just picked up a big 80 armor. Oh yeah, and if you had the movement speed boots over here, you would have been catching him way easier. Because of his flay slow and shit. Would have been way less. Here comes the big play! Ah, almost. Not really sure I agree with your items. Like, look who's fed on the enemy team. It's this Ezreal that's gonna, like, destroy you. This guy's bought, like, I don't know. They're, like, okay items, but they're not, like, I'm gonna burst the shit out of you AP items. Please build AP. Or please build magic resist. I feel like you should have definitely went armor this game. A dead man's plate would have been great. This should be a free kill. Again with those axes! Because now you don't have another axe to chain it with. Alright, just came off cooldown. See, this is what I mean. These are perfect. They're right on top of where you're going to go. There you go. I mean, it helps that he runs toward them. Okay, he missed the last one. Oh my! That creep block! Come on! But yeah, this... Like, yeah, sure, that creep block sucks, but this is all because of the first part. He had that shit. You hit him here, he's done for. If you throw a nice one that you picked up, then you kind of misclicked a little bit. But now you gotta wait. You gotta wait the cooldown. This is so unfortunate. Finally comes back up. You just tag him with the max range for this whole time because it took you so long to do everything. Yeah, you kind of could have got him in the end. You missed the last axe and you got creep blocked a little bit. But the main issue was this part right up here. Really got to stop throwing those super long max range axes. You got to throw them right in a spot that you can get them. That's what you always got to be thinking of. You got to be like, okay, I can throw an axe here and I can chain it here and I can chain it here and I can chain it here. Like, it has to be like that because that's how you get all your damage output. And that's how you can slow them so you can constantly hit. Because if he, once he pops his barrel, he gets 30% movement speed. You're not catching him at that. Especially when you have to wait 4 seconds for your axe to come back up. You just barely clipped him with the max range and was able to chain it a little bit, but it took so much time. They were able to make a play around it. You have no gold there to spend either. That's horrible. Oh, man. Yeah, I definitely feel like armor would have been the way to go. Dead man's plate. Dead man's plate, you get some extra movement speed too. Makes it a little bit easier to catch this guy. You're in a spot where you can split against Gangplank very easily. I just don't know. I just don't think you can split against Udyr. I feel like Udyr might be able to take you out. Cause you, well, you got a little bit of magic resist, but he's got 3 items finished to your 2. Not even 2 finished. One and a little over a half. So I feel like Udyr can like 1v1 you. So you can't really split. So you're gonna have to team fight. These team fights are gonna be pretty hard with this Ezreal. You guys are gonna have to somehow burst out Ezreal, or Master Yi's gonna have to pop off in a fight. I feel like this is going to be quite difficult. Yeah, and your CS fell off a cliff. You have 100 CS right now. This is really good. Oh, you can keep going. I mean, you could have played a little bit more aggressive, but yeah. It's a pretty rough fight there. If Corki was around, you guys might have been able to do something, but... Yeah, you got chunked out because you were kind of out in no man's land. After you did the wolves, you needed to really walk back around. You really shouldn't have done the wolves because you didn't have enough lifesteal to actually do them fast because you weren't spamming your axe. If you want to do wolves fast, you Q, 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 Q like that and just clear it really fast and you spend a lot of mana to do so. But if that's what you want to do, you got to do it that way because you lost a bunch of health to get a little bit of gold. Gold that you're not going to spend on items right now. So it's essentially gold that doesn't do anything, right? And then you're chunked out, so you can't defend a tower. So I don't know. Your team could have walked away from the tower and given it up a little bit easier, but you really got chunked out for no reason. And it made it so you couldn't fight at all. And your team really needs you to fight, because they need you to Ragnarok and kill the back line. The enemy's overextending. Yeah. That's so dumb. Well, enemy team's trying to finish the inhib. I mean... I think it's okay, I guess. 2 kills. It just depends on how much you guys get here. If you guys walk over to Baron, you know, they're going to be in trouble. Whoa, sick play is here. It only costs you like 300 mana. And then you have to back while you guys just do Baron. Oh yeah, Ezreal's in bot lane. You guys should do Baron. Ezreal's trying to come up. That 4k. So Udyr's here, he's gonna try and smite. Do you have level advantage on Yi? Oh, get fucking wrecked! Wow. They were even in levels too. Before he smited, he was 14. They were both 14. Damn. Well, that's just, you know. You can't do anything there. That's just kind of unfortunate. I mean, Master Yi is kind of one of the harder champions to, like, you know, combo something with, right? It's not like it's Lee Sin where you Q and then smite Q or something, but yeah. you definitely have, it's like a 60-40 advantage right there, because he's in the pit first. You're popping your Ragnarok a little too early, man. Yeah. You gotta wait till you're about to use it. Remember, it's only 6 seconds, so right before you're about to get hit by a CC is when you want to pop it. So, you keep blowing it and you're losing out on so much of its value because you blow it, like, trying to run in and shit. Well, lucky for you guys, the enemy team shoving mid lane, which isn't really going to amount to too much here because there's not a wave yet. So here comes the wave. They can Baron buff it. Wow. The Udyr Baron buff. So it's a 4v4 right now. I don't know if you guys can hold this. This Ezreal is so strong. Did you finish your items yet? Alright, nice. And you're going for a Sturrix Gauge. Okay. I don't know. I'm not sure if I really like that. I feel like Dead Man's Plate into like Sturrix Gauge would probably have been much better. I just don't feel like you need the magic resist. Like, it's okay, but like, what are you getting hit by this entire time? It's Ezreal. Like, it's all physical damage wrecking you, and you have no armor, so you need shit on. Yeah, you guys don't have very much coordination. Oh, JK! Right as I say, you guys have no coordination. The Yi flank with the amplified damage on his Q. Kid 1v5ing right now. Wow. Wow. Well, that was a big throw. Holy shit. That was really good. Vladimir got a nice 4-man ultimate, and then incoming from the flank was Master Yi. Really nice. And you were distracting people. Getting hit by Ezreal. Oh! Alright. But yeah, you definitely should have had some armor there. If you have armor, Ezreal's doing way less damage. You're getting wrecked by Ezreal in these fights. That's the one who's, like, killing you. You're not taking too much damage from Azir. You're not really the target that Udyr's hitting. Udyr's like diving your back line and shit, trying to kill Corki and Vladimir. So you're not getting hit by magic damage, so it doesn't really make sense to build it, you know? So you got a lot more value out of some armor. Plus, Gangplank's gonna like ult every fight, so that's like damage you're always gonna be taking no matter what. You know, Barrow's coming in. Yeah, it's just much more effective, I think. But yeah, you are doing nothing in the CS department. This is like a ARAM mode in Silver ELO. There's like no side wave control from either team. Unless there's like complete downtime, you guys never go to a side lane. Like, you should always be thinking like, where the fuck should I go, right? You got TP up and Gangplank can't 1v1 you anymore. So go bot lane right now. And this is actually probably a time in the game where you can shit on Udyr too in a 1v1. So bot lane should probably be where you want to head here. Like, Baron's not up. There's really nothing to do. Walking mid lane's not going to really do too much. So, yeah, you always kind of be looking where you should be going when you spawn. And bot lane's probably the answer, because you can just start pressuring this shit. And if you need to, you can TP in. Again, you're popping your ult way early. Pop it right here before you go through the box. You miss like 2 seconds of it. You're flashing 2, 1, flash. Oh, you had your flash up. Yeah, you could have flashed away there. Flash to the other side of the other side of this and make him run all the way through it. Then he would die. Because the time that takes for him to kill you, plus the time that it takes for him to run out. Yeah. This is gonna be pretty painful. It's such a, your team just opted into like really bad fights. Like Master Yi tried to like 1v9 again. Luckily the guys were able to hold, kind of. Oh man, this Ezreal damage. This is what I'm saying, dude, you need your armor. It's Ezreal. He is huge. Yeah, you're getting the memo now. You picked up some armor. This is what I mean. You should have had it over the Visage. The Visage isn't really giving you much. Nice. Alright. Finally, we're gonna get some CS. Yeah, man, you got 115 CS at 30 minutes. It's not the best as Olaf. And what you wanna do when you farm as Olaf is you just wanna queue once, go pick it up, and queue back again. That's all you gotta do, and you clear an entire wave. So queue once through everything, and then go grab it, and then queue once back through everything. And it clears the whole wave but the cannon menu. And then you hit the cannon menu once, and you queue it. And then you eat it, and it dies. Yeah. This is a problem that happens a lot in low ELO. Everybody just kind of groups and wants to like team fight all the time, which is good. You know, grouping's great, but they forget about this thing called side lanes and top and mid or top and bot like get completely forgotten about, and no one farms them. Like, look at all the farm numbers in this game. No one's above 200 at 31 minutes. That's fucking nuts. That's because everybody just keeps running mid and farms. But now you're getting the memo. You got your TP up. You're ready to go. So you should be kind of watching around. Potential TP spot right here would have been really good right now. Really good right now. Super good right now. If you have teleport, you should use it right now. Hello, teleport. Teleport! What are we looking at? Alright, there you go. Real late. But you should still be able to do something here. Pick up that axe and follow through. Yep. You should have this. You can 1v1 him, right? Keep picking those axes up. It's just sitting there. It's sitting there. All that extra damage. You got to pick those axes up. Pick it up. Once you throw it, you run to it and pick it up. You can orb walk and keep doing it. Yeah, you can get like, you could have gotten like four axes. Four more axes off right there. Very easily. But yeah, your TP was super late. If you're ever splitting late game, you need to be paying attention to the map. And you kind of just got caught. For no reason, because you ran this way instead of this way. Right? You saw him coming from that ward. You saw him right here through this ward. You know that they were going this way. It's obvious they're going to keep running through mid. So you should have just ran the safe way. You got yourself killed. Well, that's a dumb death, and dumb deaths late in the game is very, very stupid, because that's a minute that you're off the field. When you could have, like, backed and potentially gotten back here to defend with home guards, you know, at least stalled until Nautilus was up. So that's like a, you know, garbage death to really give up. Alright, now your team's clearing the side lanes. Guys going ham again, 1v9. Alright. Thresh flash exhausted him as he was ulted. He's just gonna turn him like kill. That's funny. Nice. Hysterics gauge is finished. That axe just is so far away. You could have grabbed it right there and got him again like twice already. 455. That's what you got off a dangerous game. What? Oh no, never mind. That was off the dangerous game. That was off the W. Yeah, man. You keep doing this with your axes and you overthrow them constantly. You're missing so much damage when you do that. And I think the enemy is just going to end the game. Yeah, there's a lot of bad fights that you guys had there. You didn't really use your TP much to do really anything. The two times you really used it to like make plays, they were really late. And The other time you TP'd bot to like try and kill Ezreal, which definitely wasn't gonna work because it's Ezreal and he's got shift. So the main thing, like look, you got 129 farm at 34 minutes. That's really bad. You gotta be more active with going to the side lanes. Like right when you spawn, the first thing you're looking at is like, okay, what lane is open? Is the first thing, right? And then what lane is pushing to me, right? Any lane that's pushing to you, you want to go clear that shit out and make sure it pushes back to your enemy, because then you get vision off of it. It's going to bounce back later on. You're denying them all creeps. You know, the 1,000 gold swing rule type thing is, you know, what I called it before in a video. You get that function going on. But yeah, because then you could be probably an entire, if you were doing relatively good farming, say you had like, you know, relatively good, this game would be like 270, would be, you know, pretty good. 270 would be pretty good, right? That's 150 farm more than you. That's more than you have total. You know, we're talking about you finishing another complete item at this point. And yeah, so farming's super important. So when the just don't like constantly try and group up with your team, because you guys are just like, it's a team deathmatch. I mean, look how many fucking kills are in this game. I know it's silver, I understand that, but when you have TP up, look to split. You know, you can join and pay attention to your map. Many times you were not paying attention, and well, I don't know if you're not paying attention or just hesitant on when to TP in, but you gotta pull the trigger quickly. You know, pull the trigger quickly on your TPs. That's something you really gotta learn. Personally, my TP work needs, or my TPs needs work as well, so I understand the plight, and it is a little bit difficult to constantly be watching the map and understand where you can look to TP to. But that's something you really gotta pay attention to. And then, so yeah, you should be up a lot more in farm. But you did really well. I think your axes need a little bit of work, and you got to work on landing them in an area that you'll be able to pick them up, because that's really important to keep high damage up, because it allows you to slow them so you can keep hitting them and such. So I'd work on my axe throwing, farming open lanes in the mid game and late game, and pay attention a little bit more to item buys. Like, think about who's going to hit you. You're hardly getting hit by Azir. Most of the damage that you're getting hit by was Ezreal Well, Azir would kill you like at the end of fights, but it was after you already got like chunked by Ezreal or GP most of the time. And they were the main fed people there. And he even built like, you know, relatively weak items early. But yeah, so maybe Dead Man's Plate. You could have the Dead Man's Plate if you farmed well right now. But overall, I think you played relatively good. Yeah, your bot lane was kind of atrocious, though. And there's not much you can really do against an Ezreal that gets that fed. His build was a little bit wonky, but... Alright, GG, well played. Good game, man. Peace.